What's up mga otod? Welcome back to Taurus Fishery YouTube channel! For today's video, we will be learning again and again how to make cargo net with the one and only Master Guide, Rafael Carrado!
I'd like to teach you how to make cargo net, you know? And to do cargo net, we are going to close up, you know, the process. But as of now, I would like to explain to you how did we start it. You know, we have to first choose, you know, kind of rope that we are going to use. For us, we use red and green so that the color will be contrast. And then we cut the red into pieces and then tied up each piece. And then with a certain distance, you know, with each other. Okay, going there, and then the green color will be the one that would make the horizontal line. You can see here the red is making the vertical line. Now we are in our nuts here, we are using crown nut, see, forming a square, right, so that each side will have very good tension to pull with each other when someone stepped on the, you know. Okay guys, we will be teaching you the close-up way how to make the crown nut. So we are going to that side. So what we can do is we will fold the red rope, okay, like this, right? We will make a loop at the right side, and then Paige will put the rope like that, okay, the green rope, and then turn, okay, and put it, insert it in the rope, the running part, insert it in the rope, and it will form a square, okay, formation. All right, we call it the crown knot. All right, same principle that we can apply to the other side. Okay, G-man will tighten that one. So if you are going to the right, fold the rope like this, you make a loop, then what you can do is you insert this, okay, turn, and then insert in the loop, okay, then you adjust sides to, for you to see, you know, how the it's very important, you know, to see to it that the distance of each square of the cargo net is equal. So what we can do, you can use a ruler or a stick, you know, to measure the distance, all right, between the square that we are making. So like this, it needs a little bit adjustment here so that there will be an equal size here, okay, but we can just this afternoon we have our visitor, we have Ma'am Maitel Saladaga, also a master guide and a Taurus member, and she is an elementary teacher handling pathfinders, and this afternoon she will tell us how important is cargo web to our children.
Okay, in the elementary department, one of the most exciting events that we usually hold is the Pathfinder Camp. Students really await for that event, and one of that is the adventure that they can get out of that activity. Cargo web is very important in a sense that there are many skills that students can develop through this, what we say, skills or cargo net. One of that is that the motor coordination, which is very important to develop, especially in the young years of the student. Another thing is that it can also build their confidence in conquering their fears and many more. And they, as I observed, they have much fun in this activity.
So thank you so much, ma'am. You know, thank you so much for coming. At least this will help our viewers understand why we are making this cargo web. And not only this, and not only for the kids, you know, we are also using cargo web for adults in the training of our master guides and training of other outdoor activities. Thank you so much. Okay, we are done with our cargo net and we have made at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 layers, and we can make more, and we can also make widen it if we want and lengthen it if we want, and we can also change the size of the rope. This size is small for children and for adult. We can make a bigger one, and if possible we can use the cotton, you know, cotton rope, cotton made rope, so that it will be soft. Cargo net should be soft. Commando crawl is one of the very important obstacle during camping, and many young people like commando crawl also. So we will teach you the basic of crawling on the rope. Okay, the proper way of performing commando crawl is to drop one of your legs. If you are a right-handed, then drop your right legs as your balance, and then your left leg will hitch the rope, okay, to help your hitch on the rope and your balance also, okay? So if you want to move, then you can pull the rope with your arms, okay, with lifting your body a little bit, all right? Like that, okay, and then you can move. Right, this you can crawl, you cannot crawl like a man on a rope, so what you can do is follow this way, you know. So what you can do is put your hands like this, all right, and see to it that the rope is at your symmetry, okay. And then when you move, okay, see to it that you place this rope on your legs here. Okay. Para. So good na dai.
Hi, good afternoon. What are you doing?
Hello Dayan, good afternoon. We are fine.
Yeah.
We are making spider web.
Oh, I see. What is that for?
Alright, so spider web is very useful for any outdoor activities, particularly during the camping of the pathfinders, also the master guides, and all young people who wants to enjoy their camp. But the spider web can add color, particularly to their rope courses. So children will enjoy this, and even young people.
Okay, but aside from camping, what else?
Alright, if you want to make your own playhouse, and if you want to wear your own Spider-Man cloth, then you can make your own spider web.
Okay. Good to know that.
Yeah, yes.
How did you make this one, Pastor?
Alright, okay, so first of all, we have to see to it that we have a ring here.
Okay.
Alright, supposed to be, we can use a metal ring here, but any, you know, round rope is also will do. And after that, we can also use, supposed to be, we can use you know, ice plies here at this side.
Okay.
But this time we are only using glove hitch, and we lock it with half hitch. And if you know how to do ice plies, it's much better. And you see, there is one round. We have made already one turn, or okay, And in order for you to attach these two strings here, if possible, you do, you know, continuous splicing. You apply continuous splicing so that you can have a very clean, you know, spider web. So you can just add, you know,
possible to help it to make a
spider web.
Yeah.
Well, it depends upon you how big do you want to do it. You can, you know, just make 5, 6, 7. It depends upon you. If you want to make a big spider web, then you can make more than 10 to 15 turns if you want. At the, you know, formation of the spider web, you have to first, you know, put a center point. You identify your center point, and then after that, you can make a pose. At least, first of all, you make a square, right, from here to there, right, and then also to the other side, okay? So, same distance from the middle to that pose, and you add other posts later on, okay, in between the squares in order for you to add. If you want to add the more later on, you can add more yellow ropes if you want to have a bigger and wider spider web. That's it. You know how the square will be formed.
A few moments later,
we have made our spider web with 1, 2, 3, 4 rounds, including this round that we have here, 5. Okay, now again, see, we did not just use continuous here, continuous splice, but if you can, if you will make your, you know, final spider web, you can apply continuous here and also here where the two, you know, strings are being attached. Okay, and again, you can also apply ice splice here, all right, so that it will be more secured, and the nuts are clean. Hello, basketball players. Let us imagine that this is the basketball ring, and this afternoon we will be teaching you how to make a basketball ring net. Okay, you know, sometimes we could hardly find a net and buy net in the supermarket. So what we can do is we will just buy rope and make our own net. So it will be very easy. If it is the ring, then you have to cut your rope, okay, and start by tying your rope with glove hitch. And to start with, we have to hold one part of the rope here, and then one side of the rope at the other side, and then we will place them together, right? And we will tie double slip knot, double in a sense that there are two ropes, okay? So we have a tied slip knot at this side, okay? Same with the other side, and Ariel is also tying, okay, the other part of the ring, and we will just continue tying until we can tie all the side.
5 minutes later,
we have our basketball net, you know. So all basketball players, you can start shoot your balls, okay?
So guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe our video, and hit the notification bell. Taurus.